Hey, do you remember barter system? I think you must have read it in your history book. And do you remember when the people could not, afford money to buy things? So they had this option of giving something and getting something. You give apple and you get banana. You give maybe wheat and you get rice, something like that. So that was barter system. But no, we are not going to talk about history here. So here I am, Rita Mitra, back again with you. Today at the end of the session, you'll be able to justify and use the right method of an issue as per the size and the requirement of the organization. Also, you'll be able to evaluate the need of land control to reduce the pilferage in a hotel. So when we are not hiring, as I was discussing in my previous session, when we are buying, so what are we exactly buying? We are buying a huge amount of linen, you know. If it is a linen, there is a room linen and restaurant linen. In the linen also, then there is a king bed sheet and queen size bed sheet and double size bed sheet and single bed sheet. If we talk about the restaurant linen, it will be table cloths and napkins and frills, etc. If you are going to talk about the duvets, there are different sizes of duvets and duvet covers. We talk about the towel, there are pool towels, there are hand towels, there are bath towel, there are face towel, there are bath mat, and there are bath ropes. If we talk about the pillows, there are different sizes of pillow and pillow cover. If we talk about the cushions, there are different sizes of cushion, and also there are different sizes of cushion cover. So there's a lot. When we are storing so much of linen in the hotel, so there has to be certain issue method. So some of them that we are going to discuss is fresh versus soiled, one for one. That means that you give one and you take one, not like barter system that you give banana and you get potato. Here, whatever exactly you give, the same thing you'll get. So if you're giving a hand towel, you receive a hand towel. If you're giving a single bed sheet, you receive a single bed sheet. If you're giving 10 single bed sheets, you will be getting 10 single bed sheets. So the idea is that there could be another method. There is a topping up method. Topping up method is it is a pre-prescribed or described space which is created in the shelf in the pantry. So if a particular shelf is able to hold 50 bed sheets, so you cannot put in the 51st bed sheet there. So whenever there is a continuous usage going on, if you remove 10 bed sheets from 50 bed sheets, you will be able to fix in again only 10 bed sheets. So you basically top up the shelf, and that's how you're bringing the power back again in the pantry. So the third is recreation. There can be different departments looking for different amount in different timing. So as per their requirement, they will be giving the recreation to the linen room, and the linen room is going to accordingly issue the same linen. The fourth one is a set amount. So the organization can set up an amount for every outlet or every department, whoever requires the linen, and accordingly, the set amount will be issued on a regular basis. So there can be different procedure maintained for the room linen or the F&B linen. Let's discuss about the room linen exchange process. So the first step is when the linen is exactly in the room, the chambermaid goes to the room and removes the linen which is already used by the guest. Then it will be actually brought to the pantry. In the pantry, a huge work goes on, that is sorting of the linen. The sorting can be done in many ways. It can be done in according to the color, according to the size. And this is very, very necessary, because if you mix the color or mix the size or mix the very dirty or the less dirty article, again, the laundry will be taking an extra amount of time just for sorting before actually processing the laundry. The third step is as soon as the sorting is done, the floor supervisor is going to note it down. Noting down is very, very important, because each piece of linen is very, very expensive here. Once it is noted down, it will be sent to the linen room, and the issuing method, be it one for one or topping up method, will be followed, and whatever you give, you receive back, and then it will be brought back to the floor pantry. It will be set in the floor pantry, and from floor pantry again in the next day, it is going to go to the room, and the cycle goes on. Telling you a little detail about the room linen exchange process, all the counted linen will be actually fed into a control sheet, a control form. Room linen control form will be prepared in duplicate, and once the linen room in charge receives the linen, they are going to put a received signature. Once the signature has been done, the balance amount is put into the linen form, and one copy is returned to the floor, another copy will be filed in the linen room. So as I was saying that we put the balance inside the form. So if you are giving 100 and you receive 90, you will be due with 10 bed sheets. If you're giving 150 bed sheets and you're receiving 150 bed sheets, the balance will be zero. And if you're giving 500 bed sheets and you receive only 450 bed sheets, 50 will be due. So why do you think so much balance is possible in the linen room? Let me tell you, when you're having or maintaining your own linen and you are having your own laundry goes through a lot. Who's supposed to be giving daily delivery to the linen room, and in turn the linen room is supposed to be giving it to you for your usage in the restaurant and in the linen room. I'll just give you a very simple figure which will let you know how much a laundry is going through, who's supposed to be giving you daily delivery. From every room, approximately 5 to 6 kgs of linen is coming out. In every hour, one labor is washing approximately 36 kilos of laundry. In a small hotel, 400,000 pound is washed per year. In a medium-sized hotel, approximately 1.5 million pound is washed per year. And in a large hotel, it is going as high as 8.5 million pounds per year. So you can understand how much a laundry is going through. So there is all the possibility that there will be some amount due which will be carried forward and taken care by the linen room, and the floor linen supervisor is supposed to keep a watch on that, that whatever is going to the linen room should come back to you eventually. Talking about the SOP that is followed for linen exchange in the restaurant, this is almost quite same, excepting few changes that always the restaurant linen will be having a particular timing, fixed timing. You know that all the restaurants don't open for all the 24 hours, so they have opening time. Accordingly, their need will be also in different times, so they will be also coming to the linen room for exchanging also in a different time. All the soil linen that will be fetched by the steward or the F&B personnel, they will be bringing in down to the linen room. The linen room will be definitely looking, number one thing is for the damages. Then they are going to look for the count, and then they are going to put it in the exchange register. Whatever amount comes to you as a soil to the linen room, and the same will be returned. And in case there is any balance, again similarly like in the linen room process, all the balance will be shown in the document. So tell me why should you have an SOP for any linen exchange? So I would expect that you should talk back down to your hotel from wherever you trained. If you don't know yet, then you must find out your housekeeper and must find out why are they following any SOP for linen exchange. Let's move on to another aspect of the linen control. Control, control, control. Before I say anything, I just want you to watch the video.
This is it, kiddo.
You got 4 turns left, one at a time. Drive it in deep and hope it sticks. Go!
McQueen's going inside. Chick and the King are loose.
I think McQueen is out of the race. McQueen saved
him. He's back on the track.
Float like a Cadillac, sting like a beaver.
Lightning McQueen is going to win the Piston Cup.
Come on.
I am not coming in behind you again, old man.
Oh, no.
Doc?
What are you doing, kid?
I think the King should finish his last race.
You just gave up the Piston Cup. You know that?
Nah, this grumpy old race car I know once told me something.
It's just an empty cup.
Daryl, is pushing on the last lap legal?
Hey, man, he's not really pushing him. He's just giving him a little bump draft.
Hey, what? What's going on?
That's what I call racing right there.
So what I want to say, take control of your life. Otherwise, it's going to be very, very expensive for you in future. Let's focus on our own topic today, learn control. So there can be a few steps about learn control. So one of them is routine checking of learn for appearance and hygiene standard. There's another way, quantity control of daily flow of linen. And there is a stock taking and proper documentation of linen. We'll go one by one and discuss each one of them. Talking about the first one, routine checking of the linen, what do you exactly check? So you check right linen is issued and used for the right job. What else do you check? You check all the soil linen and all the fresh linen that they are stored and sorted and provided properly. So you do spot checking of for the linen in the lockers or in the service area for the misuses, because you know many of the staffs, while they are working in the hotel and they need to shower, and if they did not get their own towel, they will simply come to the linen room and pick up one and walk out and will not bother to return it back to you, and it will be lying in the locker or maybe in the other service area. So you have to check for them. If there is a misuse, there has to be definitely some disciplinary action taken, because linen is after all very expensive thing. There has to be effective security checking system, not only inside the hotel, at exit point also, whenever the staff is going in or coming in, there should be a regular check done. Continuing with the routine checking of the linen, clear standards of washing and drying should be laid out, as because each piece of linen will require different washing time, different detergent, different drying time, and different standards to follow. You have to also make sure that a very good quality of chemicals are used, as because the life of the linen is completely lying on the chemicals that you're using. When you're purchasing linen, at that time also you will have to say whatever your budget permits, you are going to buy accordingly a very good quality of linen. You have to ensure that you are also training and educating your own staff so that they are using each piece of linen correctly, and also at the time while they have been washed and laundered or dry cleaned, that they are following each standard. You have to ensure that we try to follow three rules: reduce, reuse, and recycle. Now, reducing is a little difficult, but let me tell you, approximately a decade back, we used to have bed covers on the bed, which has been reduced, as you have seen in the hotel right now. Initially, we were using three bed sheets on the bed. Presently, what we are doing is we are using only one bed sheet and one duvet with duvet cover. So reduction is already done, and people are continuously working towards reducing furthermore. How can we reuse a linen? Reusing of linen is possible now because we are promoting green earth, green hotel. So presently in hotel, we are placing a card on the bed, on the side. If the guest is willing or supporting green movement, in that case, they can keep the card on the bed, and we will be accordingly understanding that the guest is okay with not changing the towels or okay with not changing the bed sheets for him or in his room. So that itself is going to help us reusing the same bed sheet over and over again, and will be increasing the life of linen also. Coming to recycle, recycling is also possible whenever there is a discarded linen, and if the fabric condition is good, you can cut it down and make it into a small bed sheet or a pillow cover or maybe apron, or at the time, at some time also, you can convert it into a rag, which is very, very useful in a hotel. Coming to the second point, quantity control of linen. Quantity control of linen, we have to ensure that whatever linen is exchanged, that we are maintaining the records every day properly. Specific timing for different outlets are maintained for exchanging linen, as because different outlets are opening in different times, so they will come to you in different time and exchange their linen. That will also help the linen room to ensure that there is a smooth operation in their department and there is no hustle and bustle, and they are not giving wrong amount or doing any wrong entry. We have to maintain all the proper records for all the documents. For example, In a linen room, we are keeping a record of each and every piece of linen that is coming from floors, from restaurant, from kitchen, from different staffs. Whatever comes in, that is recorded, and whatever goes out also will be recorded. This is how they are trying to keep a control over the quantity. The third is stock taking, and stock taking is a physical inventory of the linen. That means you actually physically check, count each and every piece of linen and you record them. By doing so, you will be able to find out the shortages or excess, that is also possible at times when you are not keeping a record of your makeover linen. So there is a possibility that you might suddenly get, instead of 100 bed sheet, you might get 150 bed sheet and you will not know from where it has come. So whatever it is supposed to be noted down, and this is how the EHK is going to keep a control over it. It has to be carried every 3 months at minimum, and that can be referred as a quarterly inventory, but preferably if it is done once in a month, that is the best for an organization to keep a control over the stock. Moving on to the fourth one. Fourth one is a proper documentation. All the master inventory, after the inventory is done, EHK is supposed to keep a record and analyze it. By analyzing, basically the EHK is able to find out all the losses and will be able to keep a par. Whatever fabrics are rolling in the hotel and whatever is the par, if you find any discrepancy or losses, you'll be able to know what to order, how much to order, when to order. Precisely, this can be done once in a year, and all these completed records should be provided to general manager and then to the accounts department so that they can actually do the calculation of cost per occupied room, find out the losses, and also inform the exit housekeeper, who will be able to make a departmental budget with the help of the report that you get it from the accounts department. Coming to the checklist that can help you to reduce damage or any kind of a pilferage, and that you can take care of it. Out of which, number one, have you seen Dunstan checks in? If you see, you will know. The monkey fell down the chute, and I'm sure it must have hurt. So if the linen is coming down from every floor every day to the laundry through a laundry chute, this linen is going through abrasion, and that can also invariably damage some part of the linen. So if you're wiping some sharp object or knife with the linen, in that case, mind it, there will be some damage done to your fabric, so please don't do it. Careful handling of the bed sheets, that while you are removing it from the bed, don't just in a hustle and bustle pull it hard, because it will definitely tear out. So you have to be very careful while you're even stripping the bed sheets from the bed. All the dusters that you're using, they should be color coded or numbered. Something should be done so that you can know which one is to be used where, specifically for hygienic reason. Hotels should definitely provide shoe shining pads or shoe shining mitt in the guest rooms, and also shoe shiners in the floors everywhere in the staff area, so that not only just the guests but the staffs, who may also have a tendency of using our hand towels, face towels, for wiping their shoe, and definitely that's not good. I'm sure you must have seen something happening like that, so please ensure that you are providing shoe shining pads in the guest room. Controlling over usage of the bleach. Bleach is something that will spoil your fabric very badly. So, unless it is really necessary, never use bleach. Insufficient stock. You know, we all need rest, so does the linen. If you're not giving a proper rest to our linen, the linen is going to go through wash every day. I'll just tell you an example. If you see any kitchen cloth at home, you'll find the kitchen cloth is worn out in a month's time, but which is made of cotton, but the shirt that you're wearing with made of the same cotton will be used years after years. So that I just want to prove that something that you're washing every day with soap and detergent and bleach and warm water, cold water, there will be considerable damage done and will wear out very, very fast. So you have to keep a control over there also. Some more things that you can do is, whenever there is a small tear, immediately have it repaired. If there is a small stain or any stain, have it treated as soon as possible. Whenever you are storing them in the racks, Like at home, what do? We use naphthalene or something like that so that our garments don't get infested. In hotel, we use much, much more than that of linen stored in the linen room. So if you're not taking care of the light in the linen room, of the air in the linen room, definitely there will be a chances of pest infestation in your linen. And obviously, without using, you may have to just throw them out in the dustbin, which is definitely not good. You must check for any sharp edges or nails protruding out from the linen trolley, your chute, so that when the linens are put into that, that they are not getting torn by getting stuck on those nails. A very, very important thing that whenever you're storing linen somewhere, that area should never be damp, because dampness in an area will create mildew, and mind it, mildew stain is something that never goes with any kind of chemical. So that stays with you and they will be giving a very, very bad smell. So you will not be able to use it at all again. So tell me why. Tell me why there should be a regular checking of the linen. And I also want to know from you that why should you do inventory in a regular intervals? I'm sure you must have seen this happening in the hotel. If you don't remember, I'll request you to please go back and find out once again and keep your mind clear, why are we doing this? So let's summarize the session. We today learned about the linen issue methods, that is fresh first soil, top up, requisition and set amount. We learned about how do we exchange the room linen and also the food and beverage linen. We have learned few methods of reducing pilferage, that is by routine checking, by keeping a quantity control, quality control of linen, by stock taking and maintaining records. Let me tell you, stock taking and maintaining records will be dealt with another session in much detailed form that we have done today. And lastly, we did decided about how can we take control of our linen to reduce the damage and pilferage. Always remember, the things that we do not value much are the things we do not have control over it. So value your linen and I'm sure you will have a good control over it. With this, I, Rita Mitra, signing off. Thank you very much. Stay safe, stay healthy.